Hey photographers, I am Keita of Keita the Explorer Photography, and today we are going into our June photo challenge. So today's photo challenge is going to be about removing people from your background in Adobe Photoshop. So stick with me as I show you how to do it, at least one technique how to do it. Obviously there are a lot of different techniques that you can do to remove people. There are different software, there's different things you can do, but I'm going to show you what I do with this one photo. So let's get into today's video. And before we do, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and a notification bell. It is free for you to do so, and it helps me provide more and better content to you in the future. If you're already a subscriber, thank you so much. I truly appreciate it. Now let's get into this June photo challenge. All right, it is time to get into this demonstration. I have started the clock, so let's get going. So I'm in Adobe Photoshop, and the first thing I'm going to do is duplicate the layer. As always, duplicate your layer, because if you need to start from scratch, you can always go back and start from there and not have to hit the undo button. And sometimes if you get too far in the steps, you can't go all the way back with undo. So we're going to duplicate that layer. So as you can see, this is a photo from January 2023 with a client of mine. It is not edited, but I'm going to remove these two guys in the background, the one with the blue shirt and one with the purple shirt, because they're kind of clashing with the photo, okay? There's people in the background in those shadows. We want them back there with the shadows or just gone completely. So I'm gonna show you two different methods on how to remove the people. First off, let's get selecting one of the individuals here. So we're gonna make this photo bigger. So I'm gonna go to 100%. And I am going to click on the quick selection tool. You do not want to click on select subject because it's going to select her. We want to select one of these guys. So I want to start off with the guy on the left. And it doesn't have to be perfect because remember, we're going to blend him into the shadows, right? Ooh, too far, too far. And so now you see we have him selected, but we want to make sure everything, even like the fuzziness of the sweater that could cause a little glow around the individual, is also selected. So we're going to go to select and go to modify and expand. We're going to just expand by 10 pixels and click OK. And as you can see, that selection has went out further away from this person that we're going to remove. So the first thing we're going to do is go to edit, and we're going to go to generative fill. And I'm gonna show you these two different methods to show you how easy it is compared to the other option and what it looks like. So that's why we have these two people here to help you see that. So with generative fill, you're going to have to tell Adobe Photoshop what to do. So with this prompt, you're going to say, blend person into the background shadows and click on generate. And as you can see, it is generating, it is going quite fast, not taking much time at all. And hopefully in just a moment we have, and there it is, yes. So as you can see, it's okay. Could do a little bit of editing. You could go back and change the prompt. There is also some options down here. There's three options that you can choose from. This is the first one. Let's go to the second one. That one looks a little bit better. And then the third one, they put a whole new person there, which is funny, but at least the person is in the background. These options, I'm like, this one looks okay. But then it's like that's just kind of weird. And then the third one, I think that one's actually the best, even though they put a whole new different person there, but that one actually kind of fits with the scene. So this is the generative fill option. Now the next option, select this person. So we're gonna select this person on the right. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect, but you still wanna make sure he is fully selected, and you wanna make sure it never selects your actual subject so it doesn't tamper with her. So with this option, we're going to go to Content Aware Fill. So with Content Aware Fill, all this green area that you see here is what is selecting to replace your photo with or your selection with. And on the right is a preview of what it's going to look like. So we're going to blow this up so you can see. So you want to make sure you remove anything you don't want to have in the photo. We're actually going to make this smaller so we can do this a little quicker. So you don't want anything that shouldn't be representative of the photo. And as you do that, it will update a preview here. So make sure we take that. We're gonna take that out. Let that go back. Oh, you know what I didn't do? We gotta go back, cancel. Oh my gosh, I did not expand. I gotta go select, modify, expand, click 10. Okay, now we're gonna go back and do the content aware fill really quickly here and just remove the green that I don't want it to select. And if you didn't notice when I went back to do that, if you would have looked over, there was this like glow from the outline of the original person. So you want to make sure you always do that expand there. And let's see. And as you can see, as I remove green, it will change what this looks like. It definitely gets difficult because you're like, what is happening? And you have to keep adjusting it until you get it exactly the way you want. This is probably the best that I can get it. I would probably have to do some additional editing, but I'm gonna click apply and click okay, remove the selection. So now you can see this is how it looks. So let's do a before and after from a distance and up close. So this is the before, here's the after. And then if we go in up close, here's the before and here is the after. Now with the generative fill situation here, if you don't like this, whatever it's doing here, you can always change the prompt. And I'm going to change it to remove person into the background shadows. And you can regenerate and see what you get by doing that. But as you can see, generative fill compared to the content aware fill is definitely faster. It's doing the work for you. And it comes out way better, in my opinion, than the content aware fill. So here are some more options to deal with here, which I don't know what's happening here, but this actually looks better. Okay, so we are done. This is how long it took me to show you two different methods of removing someone from the background. So generative fill, as well as content aware fill. And I showed you how to redo the prompt with the generative fill. So if you enjoyed this video, please make sure you hit the like button. If you have any questions about this video, please leave them down below in the comment box. Make sure you share this video with your friends, family, and social media networks. Please make sure you hit the subscribe button and a notification bell. It is free for you to do so. It helps me provide more and better content to you in the future. And if you're already subscribed, thank you so much. I truly appreciate it. Also, please support my business even further by buying a print from ketotheexplorer.darkroom.com, or you can book a photo session with me if you're ever in the Atlanta area by emailing me at info@ketotheexplorer.com. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day now, wherever in the world you are. Bye.